My throat hurts. So there may not be as much talking, but I'll try to make it work. This is part two. Watch the previous part. We just need to get into the work. There's going to be less volume of work this evening, but there's going to be more difficult and tedious work. So there's less work, it's just that the work is less fun. I need to stop by. Oh, actually. Oh, I just missed my B-reel. That's really annoying. And a good title as well for my B-reel. It was going to be my story. God. I hope I don't have COVID again. Anyway, Theophrastus was an ancient writer, poet, and philosopher from a place, writing in the 3rd century BC. His work covers areas in physics, metaphysics, and ethics. His work in philosophy covers the moral behavior of characters and how they act and are perceived. In these works, Theophrastus offers moral guidance in these works, where our main character is given a single personality trait. Theophrastus places the character in situations where their actions and reactions are captured and illustrate their moral virtues. He writes this to inform to his readers what he believes to be moral and immoral. He writes this to inform to his readers what he believes to be moral and immoral behaviors. Behaviors in society. Although born in Lesbos, Theophrastus moved to Athens and studied under Plato alongside Aristotle. In his work, Theophrastus chose that rate in his work, Theophrastus shows that the individual, through example, detailing their reaction. Presents presents his moral guidance. To the individual, for example, detailing their reactions to scenarios and how they choose to solve or avoid potential issues. The phrase does not directly state what the consequences of their actions is or why they are good or bad. To his readers, Theophrastus largely relies on a show don't tell style of writing, and this is the sort of style that was mimicked in the writing of The Envious Man. Okay. I need to write 600 words. That's all I need to do. The first sentence opens in the traditional manner, stating the type of man and the first thing they typically would do. This sort of opening can be found in many other of Theophrastus's characters. The first sentence continues on to describe the scene during dinner. The dinner table scene I can't spell scene. How many scenes in a movie? Is very typical of his work and can be found in many books, such as Kolasak, The scene is very typical because it does a good job. Theophrastus three of Rastra's often uses very familiar and relatable scenes to set his stories, to set his scenarios, to place his in perhaps to make these it may also be that by placing these characters in very ordinary situations, it highlights and draws more attention to the extraordinary behavior. Seeing is very typical because it does a good job showing up. The dinner scene is very typical because it does a good job of scenario. This dinner scene is very typical because it does a good job of showing a scenario which involves in this context, in this this context, it is considered no more reason. In this context, The story of the Cowardly Man is set during a battle. And so I used it as it would have been typical And so I too used it as the location would have been familiar and so there is precedence for me to use it. And it would be another scenario familiar to the reader. In The Boastful Man, it talks about a person accompanying Alexander the Great's conquest. This gives us an idea of when these characters were written about. And so I selected a very particular battle. As it takes place only a few years after Alexander's campaign, and a battle that was particularly difficult for the average soldier. completely forgot what it was. The third sentence, which takes place during a battle, was created by combining one element from the cowardly man and another from the boastful man. The story of the cowardly man is set during a battle and is so there precedence press press it. I just checked what T series was at in terms of subscribers. I don't know how I got to that thought. Oh yeah, I was just looking and thinking, so I was asked why I don't tell my friends that I'm about to stream. And the reason for that is if I'm doing something interesting, like playing a game or something fun where I'm talking for long periods of time, then yeah, sure, I'll tell my friends. But now that I'm just sort of sitting and working, it's quite boring. And so I don't want to waste their time. And also, I don't want to get sort of viewer fatigue in that if I keep bringing them or trying to persuade them to watch me do my work, it'll get very boring for them. And so when I'm actually going to do something interesting and fun, they may be a little tired. Yeah, so that's my thinking. And when thinking about viewer fatigue and subscriber fatigue, I was thinking about PewDiePie versus T-Series when PewDiePie suffered subscriber fatigue, really after it ended, their race. And I just saw T-Series, and it's only been maybe 2 years, or possibly 3 years since it ended their rivalry. And T-Series is at 230 something million. Very interesting. Also, the idea of having a traveling companion itself is, additionally, the idea of having a traveling companion side character is also something that Theophrastus introduces. Element Theophrastus. Companion. Additionally, the idea of having a travelling companion side character is also an element. Yeah, okay, that's fine. This theme continues in the next sentence. Oh, for fuck's sake, hold on. This theme continues in the next sentence, where again he is comparing the attention that he receives to the attention that is paid to others. This scene. Which is inspired by many mentions of trials and debts. of his opponent instead. Of preparing his own statement. This was supposed to be a exercise in just spell checking, really, and making sure everything makes sense. But I'm sort of making changes slightly larger than I imagined, and I have more changes to do. And I need to write a conclusion. The next sentence. In the next sentence, the character is openly comparing the bride of another person with his own wife. It is designed to show the level of jealousy of an individual, while also betraying how utterly oblivious the character is to how his behavior is perceived by others around him. In the sentence, the envious man has become so jealous that he has become speaking his mind without really considering the situation going on around him. This continues in another form. This continues in a different form in the next sentence when he comments on the athletes and makes a comparison between their abilities and his own. In this scenario, this scenario was engineered as to be very relatable to the audience. This is just annoying. This continues in a different form in the next sentence when he comments on the on athletes and makes a comparison between their abilities and his own. This scenario was engineered as to be very relatable to the reader. This scenario was written as to be very relatable to the reader. Such a notion. It's not about being relatable. The scenario was written to further indicate the level of jealousy of the envious man. This story was written to further indicate the level of jealousy. The It shows that he cannot sit back and enjoy the games without trying to bring attention to him. Seek attention for himself. I used the word himself three times in this sentence. Let's try to change it. It shows that he cannot allow himself to sit back and enjoy the games without trying to bring attention onto himself and force. Where he is not required. Scenarios in Theophrastus characters are usually set in a few environments. These environments can be conversations, in its trials and weddings and the marketplace. This work on moral guidance. I have things that I could write here in this essay to make it more personalized, but I can't because it's unprofessional. Because it's okay, so Aristotle considers character traits and philosophy and virtue, or virtuous nature of people. So if you look at an example, let's say bravery. If that's sort of the middle ground and is very virtuous, brave men are considered virtuous. If you're not brave, if you're a coward, if you're an excessively cowardly person, you're lacking in bravery, which means you're not virtuous because you're not very, this particular trait isn't very productive. Whereas you, if you're too far the other way, in that you're so brave or excessively naive about danger, that's not virtuous. That will get you in trouble. And so there's a middle ground to this. And when doing work on the envious man, excessive jealousy. On the flip side, you'd get the rather relaxed man who doesn't care about his standings amongst his peers and would rather then fall behind. I think that's an element of it. in the original version of The Envious Man, the character would walk the streets and compare himself compare houses on the hills to those his house to those on the hills. But after doing some research, it has become clear that in ancient Athens, rich houses weren't always built on hills. The idea of houses on hills may have been influenced by Roman or even modern depictions of wealthy homes. In ancient Athens, houses were fairly simple. But richer houses, but the houses of aristocrats would have been located in wealthier districts. The idea of houses on hills. Houses on hills may be by Roman or even modern depictions of wealthy homes. In ancient Athens, houses were fairly simple, but the houses of aristocrats would have been located in wealthier districts. Athenian aristocrats indicated their wealth by the size the clothing, jewelry, slaves, they also showed expressed their wealth by throwing lavish parties. And so it would make sense that the envious man was not jealous by what he can see, but what he could hear coming from courtyards. Of these powerful people, Is the aristocrat indicated the wealth by the number and quality of the clothing, jewellery, and slaves they own? They also trace their wealth by throwing lavish extravagant parties. So it would make sense that the envious man was not jealous by what he can see. He could see, but rather what he could hear coming from the courtyards of these powerful people. when he sits with his brothers. Coming from the courtyards. The penultimate sentence would discuss the envious man being jealous of the merriment he was hearing from his neighbor. While being surrounded by his family during a feast, but his attention would be captured in order to improve the accuracy of this sketch, the last two sentences were combined and altered. In order to accommodate this new information. Now restructuring the ending the last sentence features the envious man walking home whilst being distracted by a party occurring at his neighbor's. Additionally, I cut the mention of the envious man having brothers and sisters. This sentence highlights that despite having a home and a family, and a feast, the envious man is still jealous of what others have. Additionally, I decided to cut the mention of his brothers and sisters in order to further emphasize a divide between what the envious man has and what his neighbor has. Additionally, although I am aware that it doesn't technically make sense for the wealthy person to be his neighbor, because wealthy people the wealthier people would find themselves in different districts. But in order for this sentence to function and have the intended effect, a little bit of creative license needs to be taken. I'm going to read it again. Actually, I'm going to make a few alterations. Highlights the envious man's desires in clothing, because for the wealthy Athenian, good clothes were a status symbol. Socrates and the Oracle at Delphi. Additionally, Socrates visits Delphi which leads to him asking in his philosophies in his philosophies Socrates visits Delphi. Determine who believes him to be the wisest. Of the Greeks. Socrates. Which leads him to ask other people who are considered wise question other people who are wise. And in his philosophies, And in his philosophies, he concludes that he is wiser than the others because he knows that there are things that he doesn't know. He does not claim to know what he doesn't know. Of comparison. Continues. The inclusion of the brothers the inclusion of his brother's wife being younger and the sounds from his neighbor being that of youth. Was used because, regardless of which era you're living in, being young is always desired. This is a recurring theme through this sketch as the athletes character is jealous of the athletes. Since being young and athletic are often something one desires. And therefore is a concept that would be familiar to the reader. And looked upon by jealousy. is a sign of youth. And is I keep forgetting I'm streaming. This is bad. Additionally, although not expressly mentioned, his friend's beautiful wife to be young. The beautiful bride can also be a symbol of jealousy of youth. Explicitly. Be considered to be young because beauty is a sign of youth, and also the culture of ancient Athens resulted in women being wed young. In short, the Envious Man sketch mirrors a lot of elements of the original Theophrastus characters. It includes much of the same settings, with the exception of the marketplace. Which did in exist in the original draft, but had to be cut. Because his actions could not be explained by other traits. They didn't fit in well with the other elements. It did not fit, complement the other elements of the sketch. Its main feature highlighting the trait. Who is excessively jealous? Of what others have. His antithesis could be a person who equally lacks virtue because they care so little about how they are compared to others. Which could hold them back in other ways. So the ideal would be something in between these two excessive behaviors, which is something that Aristotle covers in his work. Okay, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. It's past 3 o'clock in the morning. I need to get up by, I don't know, to finish this off. I've written more words than I should have. I've written. Over 100 more words than I should have, and my conclusion isn't finished yet, not to my liking, and I still have a few other elements to include that I haven't yet. Yeah. So thank you for watching, and I hope I see you tomorrow. Will I see you tomorrow? No, I don't think I will. I'll won't see you tomorrow. I may not see you Tuesday. I'll try for Wednesday. We'll see how it goes. Thanks for watching.